So I was going through my book randomly, just hunting for outdated topics and updating them. And I found this tissue topic about the tissue add-on, which is pretty interesting, and I hadn't used this add-on for years. So I figured I would make a updated version of it. And although the add-on still works pretty much the same in Blender 4.3.2, I thought it would be interesting to do a new video about it. And to make it a bit more interesting this time, instead of a sphere, I used these human base meshes from the Blender Studio. And you can download this from the Blender Demo Scenes page. To download it, just click on this. And while we're downloading, we come to this page, which urges us to donate to Blender. It's pretty shocking that less than 0.1% of users donate to Blender. So definitely something to consider, even if you just pay one time. Once you extract the download, then you get this blend file, which contains all the assets. And as you can see, they are already marked as assets. So you don't actually need to do anything in this file. You don't even need to open it really. And all you need to do is save it in a location where you can just keep it there. So don't keep it on your desktop. Don't keep it in your downloads folder. Keep it in like a 3D assets folder on a hard drive somewhere. And then in preferences, you can set the file paths. So under file paths, you just add wherever you keep it, and it will just add it to your asset browser from then on. So once you have an asset browser open, then you can just find it here. So you can find it in the drop-down human base meshes bundle, and then you can just drag and drop these assets. And one more thing about that, I think by default, this is set to append, but if not, then just choose append here. And to use these assets, super easy, you just drag and drop them. But I would recommend, because now this is something that you cannot edit, before you click anywhere, open this add collection panel and uncheck instance, because otherwise it's just an instance and you won't be able to do anything with it. So let me just select this and then Alt G to reset its location. And then I can just close this asset browser like this. And then to install the tissue add-on, you go to get extensions and you just type tissue and then you just click on install. And after that, it will also be in the add-ons. And then you can find it here in the option panel, the tissue tab. I'm just going to add two levels of subdivision with Control 2. And then I'm just going to apply it with Control A and Visual Geometry to Mesh. So now we have a lot more geometry to work with, which will be interesting with the tissue add-on. And I'm just going to check that the scale is applied, and it looks like the scale is a bit different than one. So I'm just going to apply the scale as well. So Control A and choose scale. And just click on apply. And let's turn on shade smooth. And let's use a matcap. It's a bit more interesting to look at. And then let's go to weight paint mode, because we need to have a vertex group on this one. So now when I start to draw with the weight paint tool, you see that it turns red. And red means that the vertices here. So if I go to edit mode, you can see these vertices. These now have a value of 1, or a weight of 1. And if I select them, then I select not just the ones that have a value of 1, but just everything that has a value above 0 in this vertex group. So the best way to visualize those values is with this weight paint visualization, which has red as 1, blue as 0, and yeah, green and yellow and cyan and so on as everything in between. To weight paint, just left click with the mouse and paint, or to erase, you just hold Control and you paint with the mouse as well. So that just turns it into zero value. And it would be nice if we can mirror this symmetrically automatically. So in the brush panel, go to symmetry and just click on the X here. And then as you can see, it will mirror that to the other side on the X axis or whatever axis that you need. And for some reason, I have had the experience that I had to uncheck the mirror vertex group option before it worked. And indeed, if I turn it off, it still mirrors the vertex group. So I'm not sure what that option is for. But anyway, it works. And so yeah, let's draw a strange vertex group. Okay, so I've unleashed my creativity on this vertex group. And by the way, if you want, you can also soften the border. So if you hold shift, just like with painting and with sculpting, then you kind of soften the edges. You kind of you smooth it out. All right, so that's our vertex group painted. So now what we can do with this, let me just go back to object mode, is we can add a decimate modifier to this. And to see better what we're doing, I will enable in the viewport overlays the wireframe option. So even in object mode now, we can see the wireframe. And yeah, I'm just going to lower this ratio. And of course, now it's just doing a sort of general reduction of the geometry. However, if I use that vertex group that we painted, so here in the vertex group, it's just named group by default. And so now it's using the vertex group that we painted as the input for where to decimate. And this is some very interesting modern art. Maybe somebody would like to 3D print this, but I think I will increase the ratio a little bit, maybe to something like 0.4. That looks pretty interesting already. And you can also increase and decrease the ratio of the influence. And so yeah, it gives us something like this. You can also invert the vertex group by clicking on this button here. So that's also something that you can experiment with. Maybe that's more interesting in this case to make it something like this. If you're happy with your result of the decimate modifier, you can apply it. Just click on apply here. And so now this is what the geometry actually looks like. And so now let's finally use the tissue add-on. So in the tissue panel here, in the option panel, I just click on convert to dual mesh and make sure you have the object selected. So click on convert to dual mesh, and it takes a couple of seconds to do some calculations. And then what you get is this. So a very interesting kind of honeycomb structure. And yeah, to make this even more interesting, we can now add a wireframe modifier. And I think we need to reduce the thickness quite significantly here. So just reduce the thickness value. And in fact, you can also uncheck the option replace original, and that just puts the wireframe as another model on top of the original. So then you get something like this. And let me just turn off the wireframe and maybe use a more interesting matcap. So then you get something like this, which is some kind of weird futuristic mask, I guess. And yeah, you can play a bit more with the thickness. We still have that vertex group. So in fact, we could also use that here to control the thickness of these lines. So then you get something like this, which is also pretty cool. And we can also invert that vertex group again to get something like this. We still have these factor values. If you think that these lines, for example, are too thin, then you can reduce what the vertex group is doing by increasing this factor value like this. So that's just one option of the tissue add-on. And yeah, you can see how powerful it can be to use vertex groups inside of modifiers as well. And definitely also check out the talks that the author of this add-on did. They are very interesting. His name is Alessandro Zomparelli, and he talked about the tissue add-on, and he does amazing things with it. So definitely check that out as well. So if you're interested to read more about this topic, you can read about it in my ebook, and you can also find the blend file and an older version of the same topic as well. And you can ask questions about it if you want, and I will try my best to help. So thanks a lot for watching. See you later.